Now, the Roman soldier's shield is very important, just like every piece of armor is, but it is especially important because the enemy would shoot arrows at the Roman soldiers. And so the Roman soldier would have a big shield. Hold that part. And the Roman soldier had this big shield to protect him, his whole body, so that he could stand up behind it, and when he stood up behind it, it would protect him completely. He could almost hide behind it. Okay? So the Roman soldier has a shield like this, and the enemy can't shoot him with the arrows that wants to kill him. So what the Roman soldier, what the enemy would do to the soldier is they started shooting arrows with fire on their arrows. And so what the Roman soldier started doing is they took thick leather and put it on their shield to protect their shield from the fire. They would soak the shield all night long in water. So when the flaming arrows hit the shield, the water on the shield would put the fire out. Okay? In the same way, we have a shield that protects our soul from Satan's lies, his attacks. And that shield is called the shield of faith. Our faith in God makes us know that whatever Satan shoots at us, God's going to protect us. And it makes it so that we are protected in our spiritual warfare. So, again, stand therefore, every your loins girt about with
truth,
and having on the breastplate of
righteousness,
and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel, peace. Yeah. Above all, take the shield of faith, wherewith you shall be able to quench all the fire darts of the wicked, and take the helmet of salvation. I had to do it. Now, the Roman soldier had a helmet, and he had a helmet for a very good reason. To protect the head. What's in the head that's so important, guys?
The brain.
The brain bone, that's right. Because when you are fighting, you do not want your brain bone hurt. And so the Roman soldier had a helmet. Well, you know what? God tells us that spiritually, we have a helmet that will protect our minds from the lies and philosophies. So in the same way, the helmet of salvation it protects our minds from the isms and philosophies and lies of this world. Because we know that we're saved, we know that those lies cannot be true. So, everybody, say it with me. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with
truth,
and having on the breastplate of
righteousness,
and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of
faith,
wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fire darts of the wicked, and take the helmet of
salvation,
and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. Now, the Roman soldier's sword was a special kind of sword. It was not a long sword. It was not a curved sword. It was not, it had two edges, not just one. It was straight, and it was shorter than this. The reason was because it was made for close-up battle, close-up. And so it had to be short, and it was straight because it was made for blah, blah, attacking, piercing, blah, like that. And it had two edges, so it cut both ways. Well, the Bible tells us that we have a weapon that is made for close-up fighting. That's the Bible. We have a weapon that is sharper than any two-edged sword. It cuts every way it turns. And it is made to pierce even to the deepest part of our souls and spirits. The sword of the Spirit. Now, that's our weapon. So let's say it again. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with
truth,
and having on the breastplate of
righteousness,
and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, take the shield of
faith,
wherewith you shall be able to quench all the fire darts of the wicked, and take the helmet of
salvation,
and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. Now, some people think that we're done. That's it, right? Well, there's one more weapon that we have in Ephesians chapter 6. And it's in the next two words. But most people stop reading. Praying always. What we can't reach with our sword, and what we can't run to with our shoes of the gospel, and what we can't protect with our shield, we can reach by prayer. And prayer is our projectile weapon. It's like our intercontinental ballistic missiles of spiritual warfare. So, praying always. Don't forget this, my friends. Let's say it again. Saying, therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith you shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked, and take the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And what's our last weapon? Praying always, with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit. And watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. Thank you.